Greetings to all in the most precious name of our Lord, and welcome once again to this channel. And as we listen to a devotion, which is from Luke chapter 24, let us prepare ourselves this time. To begin with today's devotion, we have a song, Yeshu Christu Uyarthu Jeevikkunnu. The lyrics can be found on the screen. I would like to encourage all of us to join in singing as well when we hear this song. And there is a background music as well. Let us try to sing together three stanzas of it. Song, wonderful and a meaningful song. Let us prepare ourselves for devotion from Luke chapter 24, verses from 13 to 33. The walk down Emmaus Road is a very popular passage. Jesus sees two disciples walking and talking. And Jesus joins these two in their walk and they engage in a conversation. And during this conversation, the disciples realize that their faith was just inside them. And during this conversation, Jesus was actually reminding who Jesus was before the crucifixion. Jesus was the person who the prophets were talking about. And a person who told the events around crucifixion prior to it. In short, they were actually receiving a biography of Jesus. There are lots of biographies of famous persons that have been written, and some of them which we might have even read. I'm sure if we recollect, we'll be able to recognize many famous biographies. Why do we, or anyone for that matter, read or write biographies? because it tells us the way that a person has grown themselves in order to become the one that changed the world. It's because they provide the most valuable lessons in life. Life lessons, such as how to persevere and achieve goals, how to maintain a fair perspective and recognize other viewpoints, how to listen and to learn from others, how to learn to be independent without relying on the opinion of peers, how to take personal responsibility and accountability for your choices and actions, how to develop a love of learning, how to deal with failure, how to be kind, helpful, and considerate of others. Sometimes today, people read biographies just to satisfy their curiosity of great people, hoping that they can also discover something that was secret, some secret that made them great. In Philippians chapter 3, Saint Paul is giving us his biography. Paul was a person who learned about Jesus, but discovered Jesus as Lord when he met Jesus Christ. Earlier, when Paul looked at himself or looked at others, he considered himself to be righteous. But when he met Jesus on the Damascus Road, his transformation began into a child of God. A wonderful transaction took place. Paul lost some things, but he gained much more than what he had lost. He was proud of his Jewish heritage. He had a great reputation as a scholar and a religious leader. All of these were valuable and profitable to him. His friends should have admired his zeal. If he had been a part of the culture of that day, we would also might have said that Paul had an astounding career, astounding resume. He had every advantage. Been to the right schools, a man going places in the Jewish religious community. As great as these things were, in Paul says that these were an actual liability to him when he started knowing Jesus. He measured these treasures against what Jesus had to offer. And he realized that all that he held dear was really nothing but rubbish compared to what he had in Christ. Paul gained more than he lost. He got the knowledge of Christ. That means he got a personal relationship with Christ through faith. He received salvation. Paul started knowing Jesus in a very personal way. He lost his own self-righteousness and gained the righteousness of Christ. When he trusted Christ, he saw God put righteousness, Christ's righteousness, to his own account. When he became a Christian, it was not the end for Paul, but the beginning. He got a personal experience and a fellowship with Christ. The direction which we are headed seems right for a while. We do good things along the way. We may even think that we are going God's way, headed towards Him. However, the time comes, when we realize that it is not God's way at all, but we are headed the wrong way. We are not in God's race at all, but on a different course. We need to go on the road with Jesus Christ, and that's the reason St. Paul writes for us three metaphors so that we can understand it in easy terms. Certain biographies or characteristics of three types of people, and by being motivated by them, we can be on a journey in communion with Jesus Christ in our daily life. The three illustrations, as he mentions in his second letter to Timothy chapter 3, are the soldier, the athlete, and the farmer. See, the values of loyalty, duty, respect, selfless service, honor, integrity, and personal courage are essential for a soldier. When we are in the Lord's army, we have the obligation of obeying His orders even unto death, enduring hardship without quitting. A good soldier realizes that. And he also realizes that there will be troubles along the way, and that person is not deterred by them. Notice one more thing, that the good soldier has no higher goal in life than pleasing his superior. Who comes first in your life? Whatever or whoever it is, that is your God. Pleasing Jesus ought to be the first priority of every child of God. Second is the athlete, his discipline. Cultivating a champion's mindset is not reserved just for great athletes. It is applicable to all of us. It is a state of mind seen in people from every walk of life who aim to be the best that they can be and achieve their goals to become as strong, healthy, wealthy, and wise as possible and become the champion of their own story. You don't need a shelf full of trophies or a wall covered in medals to be successful. The NeuroTracker team and 7 Traits of Super Elite Athletes by Simon Bolter in his book Unleash the Champion Within speaks about other qualities as well which an athlete should have, which are positive and optimistic attitude, desire and motivation. These are also some of the common characteristics of every athlete. An athlete always should be willing to learn new and different tactics. Why? Because he or she needs to know the method to put him or herself at an advantage. Which means that an athlete should be a student always. It's a learning process, which is the same as a farmer. A farmer always learns. It's his way of life, hardworking as he needs to be. Learns about the environment preservation and also risk taking. Throughout the life of a farmer, lessons are taught and learned on patience and perseverance. Leslie Newbegin, the great missionary and ecumenist, was once asked whether he was a pessimist or an optimist. He simply replied that he believed in the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Many of us might have experienced near death, hearing death, whether of people or institutions, but death is overcome in Christ by resurrection. Dear brothers and sisters, now we are all in lockdown. The world is giving us lots of statistics of breakdown, depression, recession. In all of this, we have to remember that we are still on the journey with and towards Christ. This painful walk can actually become a pilgrimage towards peace. What will be tomorrow depends on the choice that we make today. Maybe now is a good time for us to become an accountant in Christ's righteousness and evaluate the things that are most best for us. When a person trusts Jesus and starts to know who Jesus is, God is not only revealing our present selves, but also the possible selves which we can see in. As an accountant, St. Paul discovered new values. We may be going the wrong way, just as Paul was thinking. We have great resumes to show God. We need to know Christ, because we may be trusting in our deficient resumes for God's acceptance. Perhaps we may think that we are born into some families who are with God, and because of our parents or our religious heritage, we might feel that we have achieved so much in life for God to accept us. It's even possible that when we look around and walk different roads of our life, we might see that we have lived life more godly than others have. But on a sliding scale, we are accepted and loved by God, Paul says that the truth is actually the opposite. Compare ourselves to God Himself, and we fall short of His perfection. Therefore, we need to strive for God's acceptance rather than the world's applause. Instead of the pride that takes us in the wrong direction, we realize that we are sinners in need of God's mercy. We need to be optimistic and motivated, like the soldier, the athlete, and farmer. May we be able to have a fellowship daily with the greatest biography who lived and is living, Jesus the Christ. May God bless us. Dear friends, thank you once again for being with me in this devotion. May God bless all of us. And if you feel that this has motivated you and will be of good use, please subscribe to this channel and also like it. Share it with your friends if you feel. And till we meet again, may God bless all of us. Thank you.